we're making burrows today.
Sweet.
Donkeys. Which is actually one of my most favorite animals to make. I get asked sometimes what my favorite... I get asked.
People ask you questions?
People ask me questions all the time about what's my favorite animal to make. And donkeys, I've been making them since day one, and they are really fun.
They're cute.
Partly because, as you might remember, I have a donkey. Had a donkey. He lives with my neighbors now. Hops. Remember Hops?
You like me more, right?
Yes.
Okay.
That's why Hops lives with the neighbors.
Right. That's what happened.
No. It's a long story. But so this is going to be a really fun project with a lot of new frontiers for our YouTube videos. It's the most advanced YouTube project that we've done, I'd say. It's got a little bit more going on than the ponies because we're going to do wired ears.
Ooh.
Yeah, that can, you know, move and be positioned. And I went a little bit bigger than the ponies, just ever so slightly. And I like to use a Sicilian donkey as my model. That's just... they're the cutest to me. So that's the, you know, the look I'm going for, if you wanted to look something up. And then we have a supply pack. So it has all the wires and wool that you need, and fiber. You will also need, well, this is not a beginner project, so hopefully you already know that you need a stabbit wabbit, and that's your felting surface, and needles, and we use swax on this project. We put, we wrap the little tiny hooves in black, and then use swax to both help the wool stay, as well as give it kind of that shine and look of a real hoof. And what else? In the, when we start filming, I'll show what's in your kit, but the donkey gets a pelt, which is made with our pre-felt, and some surrey for the mane and tail, and we're including our house carded bat, which is burrow, because really it is the best color. That's why we make it, because it's just the perfect blend of colors. So what am I forgetting, Milo? Hitting all the key points.
I think so. This is going to be exciting.
Yeah, this is going to be fun.
Normally, I hit people up with a joke right about now.
Okay.
There's a lot of jokes that use the word ass.
Yes.
Kind of every joke.
Yes. So it's going to be a little repetitive in the joke department.
I had to do a lot of work. We have a few proverbs, some very thought-provoking, deep sayings.
Good.
Yes, we're taking it up a notch.
I'm feeling deep.
Yes.
Or we're taking it down.
I deeper. Like to think, yes. But, you know, we got to start with one.
Okay, let's hear it.
What do you call a donkey with a PhD?
A donkey, I don't know, what?
A smart ass.
Oh.
we're
naturally.
Yes, we're just starting.
All right, I'll just say ass, and
yes.
Then I'll have the punchline to every
yes.
joke. Okay, we ready to get started?
Yeah,
let's do it.
I'm going to open up my supply pack and get to the wire. There's a lot of top coat and
fancy.
Yes, detail colors. So I'm going to set those aside for now. And my armature wire and my pipe cleaners. And then we have a nice big bundle of core. And I'm gonna set those aside too, because first we need to make our armature. So this is the armature, pretty simple, just like all our others. So you have a 23 inch wire and a 26 inch wire, and you're gonna start with the 23. You gonna chew on that bone the whole time there, Milo? You need a little,
got a little pent up energy.
Oral fixation?
Yes.
Find the center of your 23 inch wire, give it a good pinch, and then evenly and gently twist together 4.5 inches. The head and neck together are 4.5 inches. So that's good. Head's about 2, and the neck will be about 2.5. I'm gonna give it one more tight twist right there just to really shore up that last part. And then find the center of your second wire. Like I said, you should need to have several armature projects under your belt, so I'm not gonna go into super detail about how to make this armature because you should be pretty comfortable with it by now. We're gonna twist the two wires together on each side 2 times so that the long wire is coming back to you again. When I do this, I have to turn it around so that I can wrap both sides equally with the same direction and pressure. And then I make sure that these are coming together evenly. And sometimes it's a misalignment in the twist, like you twisted one more or tighter. But sometimes it's just a matter of adjusting the skeleton to make them line up. I want to bring these together, leaving this triangle that can stay there because we want this width between the front legs. And from this arm to the front leg to the end of the twist, I want 5.5 inches. I'll show you that one more. Yep, right there. And then bend these down. Okay. On the front legs, I'm gonna give this, they have a little like hump in their butt. So sometimes that's why his back looks a little long, because I actually put that in the armature, just a little rise right there. Okay. So at 1.5 inches, we want to do a little backwards bend, and that's the elbow. And the elbow on a pony or donkey or horse is usually in line with about the bottom of their barrel or their stomach. And then 3 inches from the elbow, we want to do another backwards bend, and that will be their little pastern. And that leaves us a good inch to fold their foot. So let me check my, I'm good. So we said 1.5 and then 3. This one's just a little, okay. And then on the back legs, we want a stifle at 1.5. So that's a forward bend because that's their knee. And then we want a hock at 1.5 and a pastern at 1.5. You're quiet, Milo. What you thinking?
I'm thinking, how do you eyeball inches like that?
With lots and lots of practice. So I have a little bit of extra wire on my front legs. I don't need quite this much. My back legs turned out just right, just enough to fold around. So I'm going to use my pliers. And what we want to do is I want to fold back a foot. So just a little roll back in the wire, but I want to leave, let me see what this is. I'm saying it's at least 1/2 inch. Yeah, 3/4 inch from the pastern to the tip of the toe or the hoof. So this actually might not be too much. I'm going to trim a little bit off. And then I'm going to fold this back. And you don't want a big loop. You want it pretty on the tight side. This one just needs a tiny bit off. And fold that back. Okay. And I'll do my hind legs. Tiny bit short, so I'm taking that one pretty tight, and then this one I'm going to use a little bit more wire. This is your opportunity to even up your legs. In general, for some reason, the legs on the left side of my animal usually end up longer. No, it's the right side. The legs on the right side end up longer than the left. I don't know. I don't know why. Okay, armature. Very close to finished. So, this is a little bit too big for one pipe cleaner to go down each, to do two legs. So, what I did was, I took one pipe cleaner. If you leave yourself about 1.5 inches off the end of the leg, that's enough to go down. I have to wrap down. I can't start at the bottom and go up. It's actually a little too much. Wrap down, and then you want to fold the pipe cleaner over the very tip of the toe so that the last thing at the end of the foot is pipe cleaner. And then I'll do this side. Always wrap down the same direction that I wrap my wool, which is using my left hand going away from me. If you're right-handed, it's probably gonna look like this. And then one of these can go up the neck and head, and then the other one can go down the back. Again, holding your armature the way that you would wrap your wool. And then we're gonna do the same thing to the hind legs. Starting at the top, give myself some extra wire or some extra pipe cleaner and come down and fold over the toe.
What did the donkey do when he got cut off in traffic?
Is this an ass joke?
It's not.
I don't know what.
He honked.
He honked. I was trying to come up with hee haw something, but I didn't make that stretch far enough.
That's one he-honked. Of the better ones.
Okay, so now you have two pipe cleaners sticking up off of here, and this can become the tail. So I try to have one come from between the hind legs and one come, I'll actually just go around the body here one time. One come from off the back and you twist them together. And then you want the tail to be checking my notes and there's no note. I'm gonna say you want the tailbone to be about 2 inches long. So I have a lot of extra here. So what I'm gonna do is fold this back. I'm gonna put some Surrey in here now because we wanna get that in here. So I'll just pick a nice little group of Surrey. And instead of folding it over, I've been letting it, because donkeys don't have a real full tip to their tail, it's kind of wispy, so I've been letting it just travel up the wire and then just twist. Wait a minute. Go ahead and set it across in there. so that it's sticking out the amount that you want. And then twist this pipe cleaner together. Like that. Okay. What I'd like to do is start with a little bit of off-white core, just get the body going. Oh, I put this piece in, you're going to have an extra piece of pipe cleaner because we just need to get the tip of the nose. So I have to cut a piece, but in case you ran up short anywhere else, there's an extra piece of pipe cleaner in there. So same thing, you just fold it back over the tip. Okay, with the off-white core, we're going to work with first about a 5-inch piece split into quarters. So I start by splitting it in half, and then I split each half into a quarter. If two seem a little thicker, I'll save those for the back legs and use these for the front. And I just start at the top and wrap down. Your wrap holds it, is what holds it, because every wrap overlaps the previous a little bit, and that's what holds it tight. So you don't have to worry about this. It's not going to go anywhere. And I just follow really tight. Donkeys have super cute little skinny legs that stick out of their big fat bellies. And keep that pastern bend so I know where it is. When I get down here, I can do a little figure eight for the pastern, but when I get to the hoof, I just want this to taper to nothing because I'm going to put that black on the hoof. So I don't want to get a big chunk of off-white down here. I just want it to disappear into nothing. And I'm going to do all 4 feet, all 4 legs, the same thing. Just one layer, nice and tight and skinny. See how my right hand, my armature hand, follows my wrapping hand down and reinforces everything that it does. So I'm just doing an extra figure eight there to start to create that little pastern joint. And if you just keep following that wisp around and smooth it out, it won't move. I'll do one hind leg. When I do the hind legs, I usually go around the body once just because it's easy to do, as opposed to the front legs where there's the shoulders in the way.
Ready for a deep donkey thought?
Yes, I need a deep donkey thought.
This is a Portuguese proverb.
Okay.
A donkey that carries you is better than a horse that throws you to the ground.
That's deep.
It's deep. It means be happy with your donkey.
It's true.
Other people might have a horse.
What if your horse is a good horse? Doesn't throw you to the ground.
I don't know. Just be happy with your donkey.
Oh, that's funny.
Oh, we got a lot of those. One can only take so many ass jokes.
You know, it's kind of like assuming that a horse is better than a donkey from the start.
Yes. I think that
depends on where you are.
I think that's pretty prevalent thinking.
If you're heading down the Grand Canyon,
you want a donkey.
You want a donkey.
Yes, I was reading facts and it talks about how they're like all terrain.
Yes. Very like very hardy. They can exist with very little food and water. That's why my donkey got so fat, because he didn't need as much grass as we had. He didn't even get any grain. He just got fat on grass. All right, 4 legs, piece of cake, 5 minutes. 5 minutes max. Now we want to start working with a little bit longer pieces because we're gonna start doing chest and body and head. So I'm gonna take more like a healthy 6-inch piece and just split it in half. Stretch it, give it a little stretch and start getting some wool everywhere else. So I'm going from the base of the neck. So see how this is just coming a little thicker right from the start. Oh, I don't want that wire sticking up there. Gonna go out to the nose, and when I get to the nose, end of the nose, I'm gonna turn around and go back. What you doing?
A little and then, behind the scenes.
And then just pull that real tight and angle back. Now I might need to stab a little bit. Strong needle, 38 or 36. All right, I'm gonna take my other half and do the chest. So the chest goes around the body, over a shoulder, and under the opposite armpit. Then to do this, the symmetrical move, you have to go over the back so that you can come under the armpit and over the shoulder, and that makes an X there. I'm just reviewing, but really, if you're doing this project, that wrap should be pretty well solidified in your repertoire. Is that the right word?
Yes, your repertoire skills.
Of needle felting skills. Okay, so another 6 to 8 inch piece. Split it in half. And I'm gonna go down the body. And then I'll take the other one and go the other way. Basically, just getting two good layers on the body here. It doesn't matter if you go back to front or front to back on these. It's a good idea to watch a video through to understand. It's like having the foresight to know where you're headed, and you'll be able to visualize the project and then hopefully, if not have better results, at least.
Some people do that.
Yes, they have a better understanding of where you're headed and have a lot of fun doing it.
Okay. Some people watch them all first.
So we're ready to do the little feet. I want to get those done, and then we'll keep building up wool until it looks like this. So cute. It's gonna come together like that. You're gonna be like, what? How did that happen? Okay, I'm gonna use the dyed black, and I want to take, I'm gonna pull off the, you have about a 6-inch piece here. I'm gonna pull off about a 1/4-inch strip and then break that down into 4 pieces, and this still might be too much, but you'll get a feel for it. You want, what you want to do is create a real thin, consistent strip to wrap. Okay, I've got hot swax. Oh, that reminds me of a Spearhead song. Okay. It's okay if I start a little higher up than the foot is going to be, because this is still going to get another color that will cover that. I don't like that's too wimpy. Let me pull that off and I can start with a more consistent piece. And I want to keep this real narrow so I can really target where it goes. And before I get to the end, I'm going to put some black swax on the tip on the pipe cleaner. And then I'm going to press this right into that. Now, if you give it like 3 seconds to cool, your fingers won't stick to it. And I'm not too worried about the very end because the swax will camouflage any pipe cleaner that's sticking out. Okay, that's it. It's got to stay skinny. They have tall, skinny little feet, not so not as defined of a hoof shape as the ponies. And then once that's on there, I can take some swax and put it right on top. Kind of just paint it on. I need a little more. This swax has a little bit of black pigment in it, but it's, oh, there we go.
Will you do one more so I can super zoom next time?
Yep.
I'm sort of out.
Okay, we'll super zoom. And
move in.
And I'm going to let this cool for a few seconds before I go trying to press it down. Because if I just press it right away, it's just going to stick to my fingers. All right, so that's good. So now it's sticking to the wool and not my fingers. And I can shape it and smooth it. Once it's swaxed, you can't needle felt into it. So you don't want to get the swax too far up because you won't be able to put wool there. All right, let's zoom in and do another one. You good?
I'm pretty zoomed. Let's see where you are.
Okay, hold on. Let me get this swax off my finger or else.
Move down stick. 2 inches.
This way?
Yes. Perfect.
Okay. Okay. So I'm going to pull really tight and keep it really skinny. Put the swax on. This is like the adhering swax layer. This is what helps your wool stay without needle felting it. Then I'm going to wait a few seconds, which is hard for me to do. And then pull tightly and press that right into it. And then just go back up just one little layer. I pull all the extra off. Can take that fringe around. And now I can put swax over the whole thing. Still good?
Yes, I think so.
Okay. And just let it cool. And you can do another layer too. The first layer sometimes just gets the wool to smooth out, and then the second layer can really buff to a smoother surface. Because it's kind of then sitting on top of the first layer. So I can just squeeze it and smooth it. I feel like it's hard to see. That's it.